Good evening. สวัสดีค่ะคุณเทพชัย
Good evening. คุณณัฐฐา you know we have been starting our program in the past several days by saying that today is another day of good news because of the low infection number, right? But tonight we want to start by saying something very, very different. We want to say today is the day of best news.
Yes, because of zero new infection and zero death. So that's very good news indeed. No new cases of COVID-19. And that means the number of death toll still remain the same at 56. So that's best news, Kun Thep Chai.
That's right. But the good news and the best news is always accompanied by caution, a warning from medical authorities. So we can be happy, we can sort of have a little celebration, but not to be too complacent and not to let our guard down. So that's a warning that we have been hearing repeatedly from medical authorities. And certainly this is something that we have to really pay attention to. Otherwise, we will not escape the possibility of a new round of infection.
Especially Dr. Tovi Sin Visanuyotin, the guy you see here, and if you have been watching our program, every day you will see how this spokesperson has come out to have press briefing every day. And he said today that he has attributed the success of zero death, zero new infection to the state of emergency and curfew, Kun Thep Chai, after the Thai authority has announced the state of emergency on the 3rd of April. Until now, we have come to this point.
So the good news today should be a major reason for the authorities concerned to decide in favor of further relaxing the restrictions. And that means that more businesses will be allowed to reopen, and those that have already reopened will be given more leeway in operating their businesses. So this is certainly something that we should be happy about. But again, we have to emphasize that we need to pay attention to the rules of social distancing.
That's right. Obviously, Thai people can be proud of what cooperation we have done together so far, and the spokesperson has complimented cooperation among Thai people. But again, as Kun Thep Chai mentioned, the word that the guard has to be high is still coming out from spokesperson, and of course we cannot be complacent. He also mentioned risk factors still remain, especially people in state quarantine, people in detention centers, and active case fighting campaign currently being carried out by health officials at the community level. So that's the situation, the level of trying to be alert still remain, Kun Thep Chai.
That's right. There is a reminder everywhere if you look around in few other countries in the region that have reopened and without any proper measure to make sure that things will not get out of hand. So some countries are already facing the possibility of a second wave of the infection. So these are certainly a strong reminder for us, I mean, to be very careful.
That's right, especially the situation in China, in South Korea, the two countries that we mentioned, particularly from yesterday, and from the interview we had with Deputy Director General from Department of Disease Control, he said we have to be very, very mindful of the situation, and we cannot underestimate coronavirus because the outbreak can come back and second wave can also happen if we are not careful.
Yeah, the key words is that the whole thing cannot be considered over until we can come up with an effective vaccine, I mean, to treat the virus. Otherwise, we cannot say that we have the situation under control. So this is something that we always need to bear in mind. Yeah.
Especially over the past 10 days, COVID-19 has been growing quite steadily, not to increase too much, with the exception of May the 4th, in which 18 new cases found among illegal immigrants in the south of Thailand. So that was the obvious days. Otherwise, other days during the past 2 weeks was quite okay in terms of the number of new infection, 10 to below 10 overall.
Okay, so let's see what will happen tomorrow, whether there will be more good news tomorrow. We have to look at things on a day-to-day basis.
That's right, especially on Friday, Khun Thepchai, as we know that this is the period of monitoring the situation. So on Friday, we expect to see major meeting among the member of CCSA to make a decision what will happen on the second phase of easing restrictions.
Yeah, a decision should be known by the middle of next week, whether when some of the other businesses that's still under sort of a control will be allowed to reopen. And of course, everybody's praying that major businesses like department stores, shopping malls will be able to reopen with some limitations, of course, because that's a sort of a part of a lifeline of people in big cities.